Am I too old for this now? Why was I even staying a fan for this long? It's been 10 years. 2012's coming, the economy's still crap. Some of this doesn't even bring me much pleasure or as much joy anymore. I go to anime cons, I don't even recognize half the people anymore. All the new animes, I'm not understanding. Is this it?
I don't know, guys. I've been asking myself a lot of questions lately. Moreover, I'm just frustrated and angry with myself and a lot of things, but the question I'm asking myself is, do I continue on with this? Because after the tsunami in Japan, and after my Japan trip was canceled, and I was waiting years for that. Now I still can't go because of the radiation, and that's not it. I've seriously asked myself a lot of questions in the last month. One of those questions I'm asking, it's kind of a stupid question. Am I getting too old for this? I mean, I'm almost 30. I'm still not married. I still don't have kids. My brother and many of the people think I'm wasting my time. They also think I should quit doing anime reviews and sketches and whatnot. That I've missed the boat. Ain't just that. I feel like I've wasted the last 10 years of my life. 10 years I don't think I can get back. I've had 3 chances and 3 opportunities to make it big. Because that's all I ever wanted was to not be a big time star, but just be pseudo something. And I failed at it 3 times. So you know what that's like? Coming so close to something that you've wanted to achieve and then 3 times failing at it. In 1998, I used to be, when I was skinny and thin, the one time I was thin in my life, before I was 17, I used to be an actor. I auditioned for parts. I actually went to Hollywood twice, years and years before American Idol, and I auditioned for parts and whatnot. Part of me is glad I didn't make it, because if not, I'd probably be a cocaine addict like Charlie Sheen or something. But what's embarrassing is that I failed miserably because I didn't bring my resume. And they asked me really easy questions that I didn't answer. So then I took video tech classes throughout high school and early college. I learned how to video edit. And then the minute I accomplished that, the minute I was certified, it's like, oh, sorry, kid, we're not using tape anymore. It's all DVD now. Everything you've done has been wasted. I hated DVD so much that I didn't even get a DVD player until a few years later after that. Then I was at college and I actually had a short TV show on college TV only, so it wasn't like national or anything, it was just local. And I didn't put any effort into that, I didn't finish that. Well, several colleagues of mine did go on to bigger and better things, including one classmate of mine, I don't even remember his exact name, I think it was Tyler or something, but he now works with Seth Rogen and all these other famous people. Well, I've just been doing this. And even by the time I finally jumped on board the YouTube bandwagon, I was already too late. Because the prime real estate of YouTube was from 2005 to 2008. After that, YouTube went downhill with lawsuits and taking videos down all over the place. And besides, so many people have become so famous off of YouTube. The angry video game nerd, the nostalgia critic, and other people who I really don't feel they deserved to become famous through YouTube. But I got in too late. And then YouTube took my channel, took everything, and I lost the momentum because of that. And the reason why I haven't seen a lot of videos uploaded, well, in February is when I made the decision to go to Japan. So I had to take extra hours working, saving up, ready to go. And then the tsunami happened, and then it honestly felt wrong for me to even talk about anime. I'm that serious. I couldn't even watch anime right after the tsunami happened. It just felt wrong. You know what I'm saying? And this past month, I've actually wondered if I'm losing my fandom too. But that's not it. I've realized that my favorite era was the prime real estate of the tsunami era. And you know, you see me complaining and bitching about Cartoon Network, Funimation, until it occurred to me. That the things I'm bitching about are 10 years long gone. You know, so many people are talking about things that I don't know what they're talking about. Every time I get caught up, technology-wise, something else comes out and sucker punches me. And I have tried to get recruited on other websites, but it occurred to me that, you know, I age slowly. Well, I mean, physically I age quickly, but the past 10 years have gone by too fast for me. To the point I realized it was time for me to grow up or something. But I don't want to stick with the real-world jobs I have until I'm 60. I'm trying to... It feels good to finally have fans. That's all I've been looking for 10 years. But it occurred to me, in just a few short time, in a year and a half, I'll be 30. And I'll still be talking about Sailor Moon? Is that really right? Especially, I'll be talking about animes that even the anime fans these days considered me to be an old fart over. I've just been doing a lot of soul searching, and I still don't have an answer. Obviously, I still want to keep doing what I'm doing. I'm just filming this because I'm thinking out loud and pondering out loud. And to answer your questions for why I haven't uploaded much lately. At first, it was both of which revolved around Japan. One was when I thought I was going, so I had to gear up for it. And after was when I couldn't go, and then I honestly didn't feel like it because it didn't feel right. Now I'm asking myself, should I?